You know, that's something that maybe we should connect you with Tom, you know, with this life coaching, you know, and you can kind of help Tom get through
Well, we can make that connection. That would be beautiful.
Everything's possible.
All right. You know, throwing axes, breaking things, blowing up cards.
Hello, Austin, Texas. You're listening to The Home Team with Troy and Wyatt, where we bring sports and money together for your education and entertainment. Brad is into, you know, life coaching.
Yeah.
And so... believe me, there's a lot of people right now that need some help.
Yeah.
Well, and you are definitely a source that they would probably need to kind of get. I'm just saying.
If you're just trying to redo and revamp your life a little bit, there's certain things you can do to do that.
You understand that the Thanksgiving Dallas, New York was the most watched football game in the history of football. 42 million people viewed into that game.
Wow. Well, we have a big Dallas Cowboy fan here with us today.
How about them Cowboys?
Oh, actually, that's even better.
He's a big Cowboy fan. Yeah. So Brad Winling's on the air with us today. We'll talk a little bit about what he does. He helps out men. A lot of people can use that right now. We'll talk a little bit about that here in a little bit.
I could too. Absolutely. So big Cowboys fan. So
yes.
What did you think? So my kind of mind was Cooper Clutch, right? And when he lost to the Eagles, I think they got away with what made him good.
Yeah,
and kind of put him in a bad situation, and he had to overcome it. And then second half, he did. But then it was Dak's turn. Dak was relatively average first couple games, and then all of a sudden we had the Minnesota game.
He went off. Yeah.
So I'm just like, so how are you feeling about that?
I tell you what, that the NFC East is a madhouse right now. I have a good buddy. He's a Washington fan, and every time the games come on, whether we win or lose, he's always sending me a text, and he's always making fun of the cow. I'm not going to say it. He says it a different way, but it's the Cowboys. He uses a different way to say it. And we rally each other up. And so it's a fun rivalry. I've been watching the Cowboys. My grandfather, he pushed it on to the family. He never missed a game. He sat and for, what, 3-4 hours every game his entire life until the day he left this earth. And it's the most amazing thing. So I've got to be a Cowboys fan the rest of my life.
No matter what, huh? Even when Dak doesn't get you to the playoffs?
Even through the Romo era and just
the
everything.
Yeah.
And Jimmy just losing my mind.
Yeah.
And I gave up on them a little bit for about 2 or 3 years. And I just, let me give myself a little space. But I came back and I said, you know what? I cannot do my grandfather or my family heritage this way.
So you sound like an alcoholic, right?
That's right. Well, I am a
he's like a recovering.
I am a self-proclaimed recovering Cowboys fan.
I had my jersey on. I was living under a bridge. And I had to, I got to get myself out of this. I got to help other people do the same.
No, you know, that's awesome. What I tell them. I go, I don't want to say, but I jumped off the wagon in per se or onto the wagon, however you want to describe it, when they re-signed Tony Romo to that big contract, and I'm like, he's literally recovering from his second or third at the time back surgery.
Oh wow.
And they gave him $100 million contract back then. That was a big contract,
right?
And I'm like, that's it, they're done. They've just crippled this franchise for a decade.
And they have.
And then they get Dak Prescott in like the late third, early fourth round, the savior. He comes in on a rookie contract while they were washing out Romo's terrible contract. Romo's contract's gone, and they flip it to, you know, I'm just like, they got so lucky, and yet they still can't. They can't
figure out how to pay people. Yeah, this is ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
They have such a good team. They have so many amazing players, so much talent, and they just can't win the game that they need to win.
We've always said this. Jerry Jones, Dallas Cowboys are the second most money-making franchise out there besides soccer, which is
Manchester
United. So if this actually hurt his pocketbook, you'd have Super Bowl. He's such a businessman. We'd have Super Bowls every year.
Yeah,
absolutely. Every year, he doesn't care. He's there for the showmanship. I don't think he's. Of course, he wants to win, but he wants to sell jerseys.
That stadium. If you haven't been to the stadium, which
I have been. Oh yeah,
we all have. Yep. It's amazing, and you know he built that planning and hoping that they were going to be there, maybe potentially hosting their own Super Bowl.
Yeah,
and look where we are.
Yeah,
but maybe this year. Maybe this is the year. This is our year.
He sounds like a Longhorn fan.
We them boys, right?
It sounds like it.
I will tell you, I'm with you on that one. Is that it's, you know, it's Charlie Brown and what's her name? Linus?
Lucy
and Charlie Brown. And right now, the Cowboys are putting that ball down on the tee for us to come up and kick the field goal.
Yeah,
and we're like, right now, we're all going from absolutely not to, okay, are you going to hold it still this time?
Yeah, it is.
And she's, just, you know, that's where we're at. We're all like, we're all wanting to jump back on and try to kick that ball. And it's going to miss. It's she's going to pull it out from underneath us. I'm just telling you, whether it's, if it's in the second round, that would be at least a good season. Yeah, she's still going to pull it out from underneath. That's my opinion. I'm with you on that.
We'll see. I mean, we were talking earlier. I think, you know, they did a trade with Dak, which they're not going to. I think they're. A backup quarterback should be their starter quarterback because they're both as good. They save some money and get some trades. They do the Herschel Walker trade.
Yes.
It's what got them a world champion. That's how you do it. That's how, if you want to win the Super Bowl, trade Zach.
There's no team that's going to pay for him because everybody's got kind of what he is.
Yeah.
Not everybody, but, you know, most teams have kind of what that are right there. You know what I'm saying? They have, you know,
you're right.
A Matt Stafford, or, you know, they have somebody that's you know, so you're not going to give up everything for just a little bit of improvement, you know?
Unless you have and we're towards the end of the season, but if you have no quarterback and all of them get injured, be a good time to trade them next year.
Yeah,
what about Tom Brady? We throw him a bone, we bring him in, he's struggling right now, we'll build him up.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
We are totally not doing what we planned because this is way better.
Yeah, I like it.
But I was going to say, you know, that's something that maybe we should connect you with Tom, you know, with this life coaching, you know, and you can kind of help Tom get through
we can make that connection, that would be beautiful. I might switch to another team, wherever he is, if that's the case.
Well, you might start coaching women if his wife wanted to, huh?
Whatever is necessary.
He's like, yeah,
necessary.
Absolutely. So, yeah, we will discuss, you know, that when we get back after the break. We'll discuss a little bit more about, you know, life coaching and things like that that you do. Hello, Austin, Texas. You're listening to The Home Team with Troy and Wyatt, where we bring sports and money together for your education and entertainment. If you have any questions about anything we say today, please reach out to us at loans. That's an S, not a Z.
All right.
Loansfromtroy.com or give me a call at 855-299-HOME. This segment is brought to you by Security National Mortgage, where we turn houses into homes by financing your American dream.
Right.
But so with that, this is the real estate segment. Of course, you know, we have our special Brad Wendling. Did I say that correctly?
It was close. Brad Wendling.
Wendling?
Two syllables.
I tried. Wendling. Really, yeah, that's kind of, yeah. Yeah. Yeah,
you still butchered it.
That's why I was messing with you. Wendling.
They called me. They would refer to me as Welding in high school to kind of make fun of me a little bit, and I had to.
Gotcha.
Well, I've known Brad forever. Right down the street, grew up with each other. So,
Time, because we're about to go over all of the real estate news. You know, Brad is into, you know, life coaching.
Yeah.
Believe me, there's a lot of people right now that need some help.
Yeah.
You are definitely a source that they would probably need to kind of get. I'm just saying.
If you're just trying to redo and revamp your life a little bit, there's certain things you can do to do that.
You know, and what's a good way if somebody is, as they're hearing today, what's a good way for them to reach out to you?
Very simply, chainsthroughpain.com. You'll find all the information that I may mention today. And you can contact me. You can sign up for coaching. You can download the smart app to your phone. And I specifically focus on empowering men to have confidence, be disciplined, and live on purpose with passion.
You know, coaching program I've ever been on is that you need to invest in yourself.
Yes.
And this is definitely one of the things. Self-help books, all that sort of stuff is investing in yourself. Some people don't think of that. But as you progress in life, you become more successful, you should be reinvesting more in yourself. So these are things that, you know, in my opinion, the more successful they are going to be the people that really need to reach out to you.
Absolutely.
So people right now who are successful or not successful, both of them can use the coaching.
Absolutely. And we should all have this mindset of we want to be lifelong learners. And I did not have that mindset a large portion of my life. And once I decided, I hit a phase in my life to where I was in a bad place. And I decided that I wanted to start fresh. And so I decided to eliminate alcohol. And I'll be celebrating 4 years sobriety January 1st, 2023.
Congratulations.
Wow, congratulations.
So that was the launch for this.
We just need to work on the Cowboys.
Absolutely.
We just need to work on the Cowboys. Yes. If you can get rid of them for 4 years, you might be in a better place. I'm just kidding. I'm fine.
So where I started was with that, I said, to exactly your point, I said, what am I doing that I am not happy with? What parts of my life am I unhappy with? What can I be doing better? And I decided that I was going to learn and grow and build myself up and create a new story, write a new story for myself, as Matthew McConaughey says.
Mm-hmm.
And I became the author of my life, and I didn't realize that I could be the author of my own life, the story of my own life. And it's so powerful once you acknowledge that and you begin to believe in yourself and you start to do these little things every day to build a new life. There's so many different things that I've done, but the most basic thing that I would suggest to anybody is to take a break, take a pause, reflect, take a look at where you are in your life and decide, maybe I'm doing well financially. That's wonderful. Maybe I have a beautiful partner that I'm have a happy marriage with, whatever the situation is, but I'm not really doing so well mentally. And I keep that to myself. And as men, we tend to bottle it up. We tend to stuff our emotions.
Well, we're not supposed to talk about it, right?
Right? We're not supposed to talk about
it. Cry, right?
Definitely not cry.
You don't cry about it. You're not supposed to complain about it. You're,
well, my grandpappy would be upset if he caught me crying.
Yeah.
My grandfather, the Cowboys fan, he would not live that down if he saw me crying. There's no way. No, I never saw him shed a tear ever.
Right.
Until his.
Until the Cowboys won?
Until the Cowboys won the Super Bowl.
Really? Yeah. He did cry?
Yes.
You're not joking.
I'm not joking.
That was the emotion that he was waiting for. Wow. So he was hardcore.
He let it all flood. The floodgates opened.
No joke. You're not even lying, huh?
No.
That's crazy. No. Okay. All right.
It's so that's where you start. You got to start and you got to look at yourself. And because if you're unhappy with yourself, how does that project out onto those around you, your family members, your friends, your coworkers, and just the people that you run into every day?
Right.
And you got to look at yourself and be like, you know what? I want to improve something. What's one way that I can do that? I can start reading books. I can find a book that's really beneficial and that's helped a lot of people. David Goggins, Can't Hurt Me. That's a powerful story of his journey, of where he came through just the depths of the darkest places in his life. And now look at him. He's just the most amazing, inspirational man that has accomplished so much because he believed in himself when nobody else did. And he built himself up. He fought through it. He never gave up.
Yeah.
And he got loud on his own through his actions. Mm-hmm. And now look who he's inspiring.
You're inspiring right now. I'm over here going, oh, what do I need to do here? I'm being serious. Yeah. You're passionate about it. I like hearing about it. So one of the things that you were talking about earlier is that you have an app, right? And so they get on to
ChangeThroughPain.com.
And there's an app on there, and you're the first 50 people get to get on the app for free?
For free, yes.
So you can get in there, kind of go through. It has little things you can work through.
There's 28 exercises that you'll go through, and it's self-paced.
Yep.
And I will be there to support you, guide you through it, answer any questions. There's a chat feature, et cetera.
Okay.
And if you decide that you want to dive deeper into a specific category, like, say, shadow work, for example, a lot of people have no idea what that is. Men, like, what are
Sounds
you talking
like a
about?
Superpower.
Sounded like right? a CIA
Yeah, like,
I'm
the, like the Marvels, like the shadow or something. Okay.
Once you discover, like, that is a real thing within yourself, your shadow, and you learn how to take ownership of it, anything is possible. And so you can say, hey, you know what? I want to sign up for one-on-one coaching, dive a little bit deeper. You can, boom, click on the link. You can send me a message, and I will send you a direct link.
Hard.
You can sign up. And we'll start working. We'll do video chats and I'll work you through everything that you need to know. I'll recommend books. I've got a men's group as well that I've started on Facebook, and they will actually participate in that group and they'll be able to share with each other. They'll learn and grow from each other.
All right.
Have book club, fire, huddles, you name it. You know,
I like it.
Everything's possible.
All right. You know? Throwing axes. Breaking things, blowing up cars.
Absolutely. No. Have you guys seen that somewhere in West Texas, Southwest Texas, near Uvalde, there is a place where you can rent tanks, real tanks.
Okay, I'm in.
I'm telling you. That's for me.
You can rent tanks
that's
things?
That's where we're going to host the first men's retreat.
Oh,
I promise you.
Okay, I'm in.
Yeah.
I get to fire the tank?
Yes. It costs extra.
Okay, I'm okay with that.
It's not cheap.
I'm okay with that.
But it's worth it.
It's
right?
like a lifelong goal right there is to blow something with a tank. That's like every little boy's dream. Like, what?
I'm telling you. It
sounds illegal, man. I don't know.
That movie with
Hey, we got going at night, undercover. It might look like a military base, guys, but don't worry about it. It's totally legit.
Yeah.
You go first, Wyatt. You jump in the tank and you fire it. If you see me running, don't worry about it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like that North Korean movie, the comedian, where Kim Jong-il takes him out and they fire the tank in the middle of the building.
That's right.
Yes, it's just like that. So, you know, and you don't have to be a dictator of your own country to fire a tank.
Apparently not. Yeah, yeah. Well, there's also places where you can actually get into fighter jets, too, like in Russia.
Yes.
Used to. I'm obviously not going over there right now to do that.
Probably not a great idea.
I don't even know how that came out, but yeah, that was probably a very bad topic to bring up right now.
I support Ukraine, just so
you know. I support Ukraine as well. But at one time, before all this, that people would go over there and they'd put you up in like a MiG or something.
That's right. Hello, Austin, Texas. You're listening to The Home Team with Troy and Wyatt, where we bring sports and money together for your education and entertainment. If you have any questions about anything you hear today, please reach out to me at loansfromtroy.com or give me a call at 855-299-HOME. And as always, this segment is brought to you by Security National Mortgage, where we turn houses into homes by financing your American dream.
I like it.
And the giggles in the intro just is because
we're doing a new YouTube thing. Yeah, I liked it.
We're YouTubing.
You did that little smile at it. You did a little wink at the camera. I liked it.
I did it before I turned it on. So that's the Home Team 512 on the YouTube channel, but it's also the Home Team 512 on the Facebook channel.
And we also are
Facebook have a channel?
They do.
And it's the Home Team 512 on the IG channel.
There you go.
On all the channels.
We're also on KBVO on Sundays as well.
Right, and that's just the home team.
That's just
because it's in the 512.
It is in the 512.
Yeah. That's kind of why we had to throw the 512 because somebody was using it in like Illinois or something. So
oh really?
Yeah,
those jerks.
Yeah, I know. I had it logoed first, so it should have been ours.
We should.
You know, it's big world, and we we can share our parts. You know, so we're not selling homes in Illinois.
Well, we could.
No.
No, you don't.
No.
Too cold.
Yeah.
Yeah, way too cold.
Yeah. It's a windy city, right?
It's in Illinois. Illinois is not the windy state. It's Chicago's the windy city.
Right, but it's the biggest city in the state, right?
Chicago?
So therefore, it's the windy state.
Yeah.
Chicago.
Right. Hey, but this is, we talk about this all the time. This is the money section of the show.
Right.
And it's very important to me because growing up, I didn't know how to use money. I didn't understand money. My parents had no clue about money.
And they listened to the show, by the way.
Yes.
Nice. Hey, guys.
To be honest, they have no clue about money today. They just don't.
That's rough.
They just don't.
You just went down on the Christmas list right now. Carmen just went, you know what? Yeah, Troy doesn't need that.
She has grandkids. Yeah. I don't get anything.
No, she's
anymore.
Like, nope, not taking care of the kids
they
either.
They all go to grandkids.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, so I get nothing anymore.
Fair enough.
So
that's how it goes.
Yeah. Yeah. So she can't use that on me anymore.
All right.
But they just didn't. They didn't understand how to teach it to me. When I was in the military, I had to teach kids as they came in how to use checkbooks. I mean, how to balance checkbooks. They just, so I realized at that point that our system that we use to grow and educate human beings in America is just not really designed to teach you how money works. That's why so few people do well with it.
Well, they teach you how to work for somebody else, and
that's
and get
the people with money.
And that's
the people with money are teaching you how to work for them so they can make more money.
And that's changing a little bit, but you're right. I mean, when we were growing up, we didn't have classes on balancing checkbooks and all that good stuff. No.
In most cases, maybe I'm speaking for myself, but my father necessarily didn't teach me those skill sets. He taught me how to work on a car, how to build a fence, which is valuable, and I use that today. Yep. But I had to figure out
They taught us how to work.
Yeah.
And that's exactly right. And that's my dad didn't either. And so that was one of the things I've worked, I talk to my oldest especially all the time. You need to be putting $400 away. If you're not putting $400 away right now, I'm just not going to speak to you ever again.
$400 a month?
Yeah. That's it. He's 25.
Yeah, okay, I get it.
It'll be worth almost $1 million when he retires.
I'm not mad at you for that, but I'm just saying a lot of 25-year-olds don't have an extra $400 a month.
Oh, they do. They all do. Every single one of them does.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because they're out buying $400 worth of avocados and liquor and
$1,000 iPhone.
They got
$400 worth of avocados. What?
Liquor. Hey,
avocados.
That's
are
a lot.
The bomb.
Okay, I'm just saying. That's a lot of avocados.
I love avocados.
But they waste their money and they don't realize it. And then they get a promotion.
Get
and what do they
you.
Do with the promotion? They just spend it. So I'm listening to The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy.
Nice.
Excellent book. And it just talks about doing the little things today.
So you're listening to it.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I said, right?
I'm just making sure. Yeah, you don't read, right? Yeah.
I mean,
you're too ADD to do that.
Yeah. I read like a page a day.
So it's as you're driving. Yeah, right? I fall asleep.
A page a day.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yes. And, but it's a great book. I've seen him in person and all this stuff. So his commentary is, it's the same. Everything he told that I heard from him 10 years ago, he's saying today. So he's very successful. And it talks about the compound effect. And we talk about compound interest all the time.
Sure.
But he's talking about the compound effect in daily habits. So
that makes sense.
If you do the little things every day, just the little things, okay. You know, he's like, hey, walk an extra 500 steps and eat 100 less calories a day. He says
every day,
just, you know.
So it's $1,000. I mean, 1,000 steps in 2 days. What you're saying?
It's 500 a day, an extra 500 a day. Extra. Whatever you're doing, add 500 steps. Steps. Okay. That could be a walk around this building, right? Okay. That's it.
Or up the stairs when the elevator doesn't work.
Yeah.
That's right. The elevator didn't work.
But I'm just saying, just add that 500, drop 100 calories a day. Right?
I like it.
He goes, he compared to someone else who walked 500 less and added 100 calories. In a year, there's no difference. In 2 years, there's a little difference. In 3 years, there's a big difference between them.
I could. It makes me think of that song, I Could Walk 500 Miles.
That is a great
song.
It
was in my head. I was going to sing it, and I was like, no, I'm not going to do that to y'all.
We got to cue that in.
He calls me ADD.
Sorry, my brain went there.
You know, but that's the thing is that daily habits and the little things about daily habits are important. And investing is important.
Right.
You know, and so it's the little things. And we were talking like yesterday, the market had a huge rally. I mean, huge. It was like, you know, 5%. And that's a big number. And typically, and I was telling you, typically I know why it's happening because I'm paying attention. We're just a lot going on in my industry right now. So I'm really focused on work. And I've kind of left my finances on autopilot. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And, but I'm doing the same things. I'm investing between the 10th and the 15th, the same amount of money, the same amount of stock. So I'm dollar cost averaging. So as everything's moving around, so I'm doing the same things. Now it's autopilot because they become compounded habits, right? And in 5 years, you know, or so from now, when it's time to, you know, look at retirement stuff, that money will have done a lot more for itself. And what happens is in times like today, when the market's shrinking and, you know, inflation and it's all scary and all that stuff, most people that don't understand money stop doing those things. They're like, okay, I'm not going to invest in the market right now. I'm going to put this over here. I'm not going to do anything. The compound effect of that in 5 years from now, and this is a way to look at your expenses. You know, okay, so I'm going to buy a jacket at Nordstrom Rack, right? Right? All right, It only cost X, you know?
Right.
Well, you need to multiply that by 5. Because that money that you put into that jacket, as an example, instead of an investment into a stock, in 5-10 years from now, you've lost 5 times what that was worth. You could have taken that money and invested it. In 10 years, it's worth 5 times that. So you look at that jacket. Let's say it's 2 foot, you know, 250, right? You're like, is the jacket worth $1,000? If you look at it like that, the answer is no. Is it worth 250? Sure. But it's not, because you put that money there instead of putting it into an investment. And that's why I say that all 25-year-olds have the $400. They just don't have the daily discipline to use it.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're getting their $20 cup of coffee.
And they have 10 streaming channels, you know? I mean, it was so funny. We went to streaming to save money. Right? That's right. Why we're cut the
that's
cord.
That's how it started.
We cut the cord.
Right?
It's cheaper to do here. Well, you look up now. Now it's like I got YouTube. I got Hulu. I got Disney Plus.
And they're killing me because if you want to see Yellowstone, you got to get Paramount.
If you want to see 1883.
Yeah, if you want to see 1883. Yeah, right. A new Disney movie's coming out and you can only watch it on Disney Plus, right? Yeah. So,
yeah. Yeah. I mean, you know, so.
They get you.
Yeah. And then, okay, but I have Pandora and I have Spotify and I have, you know, so they have all these, I'm like, really? You don't. That's the thing. And
Bumble,
right?
Your wife? No, I'm just playing.
I don't even know what that is. I'm like, I'm looking at you. I'm like, okay.
Just messing. He's like, shut up, Wyatt.
I'm like, I don't even know what that is. I thought that was the podcast.
No,
it's
a dating app. Yeah. I was kidding. You're like, I wouldn't. Even, you wouldn't even know where to start, right? You'd be like,
No. Trust me, I'm done with that.
Jackie, I was totally kidding.
Yeah.
He does not have, I'm totally playing.
I was thinking it was the Joe Rogan podcast group that tried to buy him from Canada.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, so, but that's the thing. It's there. The money's there. The discipline to use it in the right way is not. And we're hardwired.
And you need a coat because it's cold outside, but you don't need a $250 coat.
Mm.
You can go get a coat that looks just like it, didn't have the name brand on there, and Yeah. Be smart about it. Yeah.
There's still $20 coats.
Yeah.
At certain stores. And you can go buy the $20 coat. It doesn't last as long.
It's called a hoodie.
Sure. It lasts 2 years. It lasts 2 years. Okay. But so that means it'll take you, you know, 8 times 2, 16 years to equal it out. So in 16 years, yeah, sure. If your other coat lasted 16 years, you wasted your money, but it didn't.
But you have to have a coat. You can't die. You know, it's cold outside. Right.
Yeah, there's lots of options. In the, like I said, if you really want to take care of yourself and retire early and live the best life you can when it's time, then you need to do the little things now. And compounding interest is the way to do it. Starting young.
I like it.
$400, what would we do the numbers? It was like $920,000.
Yeah, something like that.
If you started at 20 and retired at 65, you'd have almost $1 million.
Who needs $925,000?
At $400 a month.
Yeah, who needs that?
$400 a month.
That's crazy. It's not much.
And, you know, at first you're like, gosh, that's not a lot of money. Because we watch TV and we see the millionaires and all that. That's all we see. But you understand that that is literally 0.2%. percent of Americans have over $1 million net worth.
Oh, really?
Yes, true net worth, cash net worth.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Didn't realize
there's a lot of people that have a lot of money in real estate and
2%.
0.2.
That's I like
two.
That. Yeah. Yeah.
0.2 have over $1 million in true cash net worth.
Oh wow. Yeah. Okay.
There are a lot of people that have some equity and real estate and all that sort of stuff, but that can go up and down and fluctuate. We're talking about actual cash. Actual stocks that have a value.
All right.
You know, real estate doesn't, honestly, it doesn't have a value, except to the county. It doesn't have a value until you sell it.
So you got to get your life in order to do all that. Men's Coaching could help out. So again, Brad, how they get a hold of you to do that?
Just go to changethroughpain.com and you'll find all the access that you need to the coaching, the Mastermind Men's app, and the Humble Man Men's Group.
All right. I like it.
Now, we have smart listeners, but I just want to make sure that it's through. It's not through.
Change through. THROUGH.
Okay.
Pain. Yeah. I'm just kidding.
Yeah. I'm with you. Never know, though.
But I'm just saying that.
Change through pain. Yeah. And we all say .com together.
Because I was like, we're gonna throw a ball at you.
Change it through.
I threw this ball at you like 50 times.
Yeah. Through change through that pain.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, so, right. No. See, now it's sunk in.
I got you. Change through pain.com. I like it.
Yeah. Absolutely. Hey, you've been listening to The Home Team with Troy and Wyatt. We hope you've enjoyed what you've heard today. If you have any questions about anything we've said, please reach out to me at loansfromtroy.com or give me a call at 855-299-HOME. And as always, this segment was brought to you by Security National Mortgage, where we turn houses into homes by financing
your
American dream. Hey, and everybody, remember, if you want to make a step up in your life, go to changethroughpain.com. And we'll see you in just a minute. Hello, Austin, Texas. You're listening to The Home Team with Troy and Wyatt, where we bring sports and money together for your education and entertainment. If you have any questions about anything we're going to say today, please reach out to me at loansfromtroy.com or give me a call at 855-299-HOME. That phone number is for loans.
That's what I was going to say. I was just going to say, now I see why people did, because you said anything we talked about today.
Yeah. Yeah, I just realized.
You gotta watch out for that. Backwards. So he has the loan. It's calling to talk about loans. Yeah. Well, every once in a while he says some things that about Dak, you know, like, hey, maybe he should sit out or whatever. And they had some people call up at his loans hotline.
Oh no!
Talking to him, going, hey, you need to tell Troy that Dak is a great quarterback and he has potential, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So anyway,
So just, you know, the phone number's for work. But if you want to talk about the Cowboys, you can definitely leave a comment at the Facebook, which is the Home Team 512. Hey, and you can even try our inaugural. Did I say that right?
Inaugural.
Yeah. Inaugural. The Home Team 512 on our YouTube channel, which will be coming out.
Good.
Very soon. So the person that's going to upload it is on vacation, so it may not be there. But it just
he's always got one person to do this and do that. you. I'm surprised you don't have a driver.
I consider myself to be like Henry Ford.
Well, oh my goodness.
Well, I'm just saying, people.
That's a pretty good one.
No. They said that Henry Ford, the people used to tease and say that he wasn't very smart, right? And so, but at one point in his time, so that he was being challenged, and he said, "Listen, I don't need to know that. I have somebody that works for me that knows
all
that.
No, agreed.
I don't need to know that. And so that's where that's how I view myself, like him.
I hope you. That's how you took it from me. You're a busy man. You're a busy guy. So I hope you know that.
Oh, yeah.
I wouldn't say.
I just wanted to compare myself to Henry Ford.
I wasn't saying you're slow.
Yeah.
You weren't just saying it. You were implying it.
Right. Yeah.
I just said you look slow. That's
well, speaking of slow, I mean, let's talk about the offensive line of the agricultural and mechanical.
They did good last week. Hey, they did real good.
You know,
they did a surprise. That honestly, okay, yes, out of the whole year, they're okay. Let's not talk about the whole year. We're talking, like you always say, we talk about one game, right? I can't talk about other games. Why we're talking about one?
Listen.
So let's talk about that one. Okay.
Oh my God, that's the worst thing about this. First of all, I want to thank Brad Windling. I said it at that time, right?
Yes.
Yes, I did. From
four syllables.
Not Windling. Windling.
Windling.
Yes. Okay. And he's from changethroughpain.com.
Uh-huh.
Definitely, I want to thank you for being here. That was some great stuff that you were talking about earlier. Now,
I love it.
I know you got Wyatt with the whole launching a tank in the middle of the night.
I'm in.
So he's in.
We're done. Yeah, you're and you showed me on the actual site we can do that.
And as soon as this is over, that's where I'm headed.
You drove the tank here, right?
Yeah.
Well, I took my helicopter. Don't worry about it.
No. It's still running.
Yeah. So if you're interested and you need some or you want to step forward in life, please reach out to Brad at changethroughpain.com.
Awesome.
He can really help you. It's very important.
Yep.
You know, so with that, like I said, we kind of want to, you know, at this part, this is what I call the fun section. This is where we talk about the greatest running back probably to ever have graced the University of Texas.
Oh, wow. The greatest?
Probably. I mean, he's...
You just went over Earl Campbell.
Right. But that's what I'm saying. But all of those, three people ahead of him. There's Cedric, Earl, and Ricky are ahead of him.
Okay.
In statistics.
Okay.
All three of them stayed 4 years, right? I mean,
you don't think he's going to stay for
him? No. Everybody's like, but. I'm like, come on, guys. I mean, the NFL is about getting to your second contract, you know? And so, you know, great. You know, you make $10 million this year, you get hurt, you're done.
Well, he's in the new minor leagues. He's getting paid.
Right.
So it's not like he's not getting paid.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's making $1 million this year.
Yeah, I mean, he might be
$1 million as a college football player, which I'm not mad at him.
And he can make that $1 million next year as an NFL running back. Well, I'm saying that those name, image, and likeness, just because he's not for the University of Texas doesn't mean those are going to go away.
I get it. Yeah. That's true,
you know,
right?
He's going to keep those. Then he's going to get the
Bijan.
Yeah, and then he's going to get the NFL name, image, and likeness, which they just call marketing contracts, right?
Right, right.
And then he's going to get his contract. So there's no way they can compete with it financially. And it's stupid for some, in my opinion.
If you're a running back, life in the NFL.
And you're that good. I mean, that good.
You only have so much that you're banging and hitting and you're, you know, getting tackled in your life. Yeah.
As a Longhorn fan, I would love for him to stay one more year. I mean, I would break down in tears and cry joy, just like your grand did at the cat.
He's going to cry either way.
Yeah.
He's going to cry.
He's crying. Don't even worry about it.
He's going to cry either way, so
you're
it's going to happen.
Just thinking about it, he's crying.
But, you know, so for the Cowboys, the Longhorns, here's the question. Last year, they went 5-7.
Right.
They had a 6-game losing streak. They snapped at the last game of the season by running the Wildcat because they didn't even have a quarterback. During the offseason, they couldn't put an orange-white scrimmage on because they didn't have enough offensive linemen for a 2-deep roster. That was the state of the program at the end of the season last year.
Mm-hmm.
This year, they're 8-4. They're 3 of their losses. Now, Oklahoma State's hard to pick, but at the time when Oklahoma State beat them, they were they were number 13 in the team, and their quarterback was playing phenomenal. Now, the Cowboys put him out. He didn't play another game. They went like 0-4 after that. When he came back, he just lost it. So but they were a good team. They just fell off after they beat the Long. But then you have Alabama, number 6 in the country.
Almost beat them today.
Yeah. TCU, number 4 in the country today. So two of your losses look good all the way through the season.
Absolutely.
One of them was an acceptable loss during the season. So you know.
What's your fourth loss?
Tech.
I just want to make sure you brought that one back up. He went over the other ones that were so positive.
But this one's great.
Yeah. But
we don't need to talk about
the other one.
But I'm just saying, so those are your losses. Yeah. You know, obviously. But
Tech
again,
was a rough one to
Tech
lose,
was
too.
Your first,
was like they were
but just, Tech was your first road game.
But they were playing
with
good.
With a quarterback who his last road game did terrible. I mean, so, you know, and then the portal hits, right?
Right.
And six, all 7, really, but 6 of them are guys that between all of them, they've probably played a half a season. All of them together, you know.
Right.
You know, they're guys with like 50 snaps in 2 years, you know, and stuff like that. Snaps, you know. But then the backup, Hudson Card's gone, and he should, right? And I'm not saying that. So now you have Arch Manning come in. You have Malik Murphy, who's been redshirting behind him. So, you know, so is that a season that people other than burnt orange bleeders like me believe is a good season for moving forward?
Well, for your average team, yes. Every team thinks that you're supposed to win the national championship or you're not good, right?
Right, but no. I mean, you know, because we are delusional.
Yeah.
Right? Well,
yeah.
I mean, I'm okay. I mean,
can y'all...
We always have
In the booth, can y'all record that and then stamp it and put that's a flag on there?
That's why this is not on the YouTube.
I want that sound bite.
Yeah.
I want that sound bite so that I can replay it for you.
That's right. Why I didn't...
This is our year.
Yeah, this is it. Yeah.
It's always our year.
Yeah.
But for the average fan of football,
okay,
was that a good season? Was that a good season that should propel you into some? Now, in my opinion, I mean, next year should be the season.
A great season, obviously. I think that you, if you have two losses, I think it was a great season.
Yeah,
four losses is a tough season.
Yeah,
it's still in my eyes. If you're playing big ball like that, it's a good show though for Texas, because it shows what I liked about Texas year. They showed improvement throughout the year.
The last game of the season was the best game of the season that defense.
And they got beat at different things, not because they kept on doing the same thing, getting beat at it. Somebody watched the right film and caught, you know, the coaches slipping.
Yeah.
And really, then they the next week they came out and they corrected it and they got better at it. The team is getting better. So next year, are they going to be better? Yes.
I am 100,000,000,000 percent excited about next year because we have two freshmen and two sophomore on our offensive line.
Right.
Our third and fourth string running backs were number one running backs in their state.
Right.
And they can't even get on the field because our first and second string were so good.
Yeah.
So we got Keelan Robbins, Jonathan Brooks, and then, you know, Blue, who was the number one running back.
Yeah.
And now we have the number one running back in the country.
That's right.
In the country. Is supposed to be coming to Texas. You know, we'll see how that all falls out. But he's supposed to be.
Oh, really?
So that would be four super running backs. So I'm not even worried about the running backs.
But why do they need four, you know?
I mean, three, you know, but I'm just saying, you know.
Well, because four is better than three.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
And five is better than four.
That's true.
You know, yeah. But
we're on to something here. Let me write this down.
You need three, and one of them can get hurt. You know, and this year we didn't actually nobody got hurt this year really bad, you know?
Yeah, knock on wood, brother.
Yeah, but, I mean,
so Aggies did have a lot of injuries. I know that's not an excuse, but they also had, I think their biggest problem was coaching.
Well, I was going to ask.
I'm just ripping the Band-Aid off.
Next year looks good. Next year looks good. Now, we have to go to Bama, which is going to be second game of the season. But
y'all play Bama again?
We go to Bama. That's an away game. So,
Well, yeah, I think.
And then we have to go to Baylor.
I think Bama's losing some steam, though, man. They're going.
They're number six in the country. You know,
a little steam. A little bit.
Oh, but when they lose the bowl game, which I think they might.
To K-State?
They're playing K-State?
You're going to win the Sugar Bowl, and the K-State is going to be the same. Yeah. You think K-State's going to
be
Bama?
I put it this way. Bama's almost
Kansas could have beat them if they'd have played a clean game.
Bama almost got beat by Texas this year. Off by a couple points?
Yeah, one.
Yeah, almost got beat by A&M by one play. It was by one point.
Backup quarterback, turned the ball over four times.
Right. But still almost beat Alabama. That doesn't matter.
If Bryce Young had played that game, you wouldn't have been close. But that's a fan that's not an Aggie.
That's an anti-Aggie fan. But that's okay.
Did the backup quarterback turn the ball over four times and one of them lead to a direct touchdown? Yes or no?
It's a yes or no question.
Check the box.
Yeah. I'm checking boxes. Yeah, we're moving on.
I'm arguing with a Democrat. All I need is facts.
Hey. Why do you want to insult people right now?
I just use facts.
But that was an insult to a group of people that,
I know. It's like I'm arguing. For you.
All right. Okay.
Sorry, my bad.
I'm just playing. Just give you a hard time. I had to put back on you. But what I was saying is Alabama's almost gotten beaten several times this year. Aggies were not a strong team this year, and they almost beat Alabama. So that's my point.
We got a question.
Okay.
We got a question. Right?
Oh, you're going to wait till the time's out so I can't see you.
Right 8-4, look at him 5-7. Oh, no. So you're 5-7. Yep. Your coach has been here 5 years.
Yeah. They can't buy him out. He's $8 million.
They can't buy him. But is he the coach of the future?
No. Well, he is. He's one of the best. He's like Mac Brown, one of the best recruiters ever, right? Mac Brown just had to get out of his own way and get an offensive coordinator so they could start making some calls, and that's what they
Mac
did.
Mac Brown needed a defensive coordinator, and they not an offensive coordinator.
Well, fair enough. Yeah. But you get it. But they have to get out of their own way and do what they're good at, stay in their lane, and hire some people that can do what he can't do, which is calling plays.
$10 million to recruit. I need that job.
Just go to changethroughpain.com, and you'll find all the access that you need to the coaching, the Mastermind Men's app, and the Humble Man Men's Group.
Welcome home.